It was a joyous moment this evening as Mulago National Referral Hospital discharged a patient who underwent a successful kidney transplant, the first of its kind in the country.
Back, the recipient, when supporting the patient, and Stephen, who donated the kidney. They are not yet free to interact with society.
According to the hospital management, the kidney donor was also discharged this week. This marks the beginning of the first ever kidney transplant program in the country.
You can operate two patients in a day or more if we have set up ourselves and we have the human resource for post-operative care. For now, we are limiting it to a few numbers as we build that capacity. And remember, there are other logistics required.
This successful transplant was aided by a team of Ugandan specialists led by Professor Frank Asimwe, together with Dr. Asashi Kirabika from Yashoda Hospitals in India. They confirmed that both the discharged patient and the donor are doing well, but they will continue to monitor them.
Celebrated so far about seven milestones. I'll go through them. For us, when we bring the graft kidney and put it in the recipient, and it reperfuses, it means it has received blood afresh, and produces urine, we celebrate. In theater, we celebrate. That celebration we made. When the donor begins getting their renal functions coming back to normal, we celebrate.
It's because he was a very healthy young man, 28-year-old man, very healthy young man. And because he's very healthy, the outcomes are usually very good. So our donor has actually, after coming out of theatre, not had any severe complications related to his operation. He's currently taking only pain-killing medication to reduce the pain from the surgery.
A kidney transplant is a surgery where a health kidney from a living or deceased donor is placed into a person whose kidneys no longer function properly. This stride comes as a relief to many who have been seeking for this service abroad and very expensively. Currently, Mulago Hospital annually administers over 1,000 dialysis sessions on patients suffering from end-stage kidney disease, referred to as kidney failure. Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.